Good morning. Now we are going to discuss about the remaining part of simple harmonic motion, that is a simple pendulum. Two topics today we are going to discuss. Actually, time period of a pendulum formula is equal to 2 pi pi root of g into 1 by l plus 1 by r. So from this, if the length of pendulum very small, L is less than radius of the earth. Radius of earth very large. 1 by r negligible. So L come to numerator, then time period of pendulum 2 pi root of L by g. This is the formula. T is equal to 2 pi root of L by g. If L is very less compared to the radius of the planet. And otherwise, we have derivation, time period of simple pendulum. So pendulum is bob is oscillating. So when it is at this position, there is a restoring force, and the restoring force F is equal to minus, actually gravitational force mg, it is resolved into two components, mg cos theta, mg sin theta. Minus mg sin theta, because it is pulling back, is equal to ma. A mm cancel. A is equal to minus g sin theta. Sin theta can be written as theta when angle is very small. So this is angle theta. So theta can be written as it is a sector. Theta is equal to x by L. L is the length of pendulum, x is this one, so theta is equal to x by L. A is equal to minus g by L, g into theta. Theta means x by L. So that is equal to minus g by L into x. So acceleration directly proportional to displacement. Hence it is a simple harmonic motion. Comparing with A is equal to minus omega square x, omega square is equal to g by L, omega is equal to root of g by L. Omega means angular frequency 2 pi by 30, 2 pi by 30, from that t is equal to 2 pi root of L by g. This is another way to get this derivation, t is equal to 2 pi root of L by g. From there, t proportional to root L, because g constant on the planet. T1 by T2 is root of L1 by L2, one formula. Another formula, T proportional to 1 by root G. Therefore, T1 by T2 is equal to root of G2 by G1, G2 by G1. One more formula, both the length and the G values are variable. T proportional to root of L by G. Therefore, T1 by T2 is equal to root of L1 by L2 into G2 by G1. And from this equation, squaring on both sides, and g is equal to, we get 4 pi square l by t square. One formula we have, t is equal to 4 pi square l by t square. Okay. So we have time period of pendulum. The length of the pendulum is very small. T is equal to 2 pi root of l by g. If length of pendulum is infinity. Length of pendulum is equal to infinity. 1 by infinity, 0. Then the time period of the pendulum, 2 pi root of r by g. So on the earth, time period of pendulum is infinity and the pendulum is oscillating on the earth. Then its time period is 84.6 minutes. 84.6 minutes. Length of pendulum is equal to infinity. And one more point, length of pendulum is equal to radius of the planet Earth, radius of Earth. So 1 by r plus 1 by r, 2 by r. So time period is 2 by root of r by 2g. That means 84.6 by root 2 minutes. The time period is 84.6 by root 2 minutes, approximately 54 minutes something. So these are the three formulas. When length of pendulum is very small, length of pendulum infinity, length of pendulum equal to radius of Earth. Okay. And time period of simple pendulum. If you take simple pendulum, the time period depends on length and angle relationship to gravity. It does not depend on amplitude of oscillation. Amplitude of oscillation and mass of the bulb also does not depend on mass of the bulb. If you plot L and T graph, L and T, see, L graph, we get a hyperbola curve like this. And L T square graph, L T square graph is a straight line. L T square graph is this. L T graph is this. Okay, and the next second pendulum. Second pendulum means the time period is 2 seconds, that is called second pendulum. The length of second pendulum on the Earth, substitute t is equal to 2 seconds here and simplify. Length of second pendulum on the Earth is 1 meter. 1 meter. And if you go from equator to poles, time period of pendulum. Time period of pendulum decreases because G value maximum at the poles and minimum at equator, G value is increasing. So that's why time period decreases if you go from equator to poles of the Earth. If you go to center of Earth G is 0. So time period become infinity. Time period become infinity. Our pendulum does not oscillate. Pendulum does not oscillate. If I cut the center of Earth, in artificial satellite and in freely falling lift also. So in freely falling lift, in artificial satellite and at the center of Earth, time period of pendulum is infinity and pendulum does not oscillate. Pendulum does not oscillate or time period is infinity. Both are correct. Simple problems. 1. Length of pendulum doubled. What happened to the time period? So T1 by T2 is root of L1 by L2. So T by T2 is equal to root of L by 2L. L will cancel. L is 1 by 2. T2 is equal to root 2. Length of pendulum doubled. Time period increased by root 2 times. Length of pendulum increased by length of pendulum increased by 44%. Length is increased by 44%. What happened to the time period? Then T1 by T2 is equal to root of 100 by 144, that is 10 by 12. Initial value we have to take 100, final value become 144 because it is increased by 44%. Percentage means per 100. Then I make numerator again 100. That means denominator become 120. Then time period increased by 20%. Third problem. Length of pendulum increased by 3%. What is percentage increase in time period? T proportional to total. Length is increased by 3%. So formula power into percentage. So length depends on time period depends on length and length power is this one root of and 1 by 2. Power into percentage, small percentages. So power 1 by 2 into 3. So 1.5%. Time period increases by 1.5%. So these three models are important models. Next, Then the stationary length of pendulum is L, time period is T. Now length is increased by 10 centimeter, L plus 10, time period is T1. Length decreased by 10 centimeter, time period is T2. Apply the relation between T, T1, T2. One question. So time period is equal to 2 by root of L by G. Therefore, L is equal to G T square by 4 pi square. L is equal to G T square by 4 pi square. Here, L plus 10. So, time period is equal to 2 pi root of L, 1, L plus 10 by G. So, squaring on both sides, L plus 10 is equal to G T 1 square by 4 pi square. Similarly, L minus 10 is equal to G T2 square by 4 pi square. Adding these two equations, we get tan 2L is equal to G by 4 pi square into T1 square plus T2 square. So, substitute L value here. So, we get 2 into G T square by 4 pi square is equal to G by 4 pi square into T1 square plus T2 square. So, G is cancel, 4 pi square cancel. Therefore, we get T square is equal to T1 square plus T2 square divided by T. That is the relation between T, T1, T2. T, T1, T2 relation. Similarly, one more problem. One lift is stationary, one pendulum is there, time period is T. Stationary lift and acceleration 0. Lift is moving up with an acceleration A, time period is T1. So T is equal to 2 pi root of L by G. T1 is equal to 2 pi root of L by G plus A. L by G plus A. And lift the same lift moving down with an acceleration A, time period T2 into 2 pi root of L by G minus A. Okay, now apply the relation between T, T1, T2. Apply the relation between T, T1, T2. Okay, so similar way we can do that problem. First, we calculate G. G is equal to 4 pi square L by T square. G plus A is equal to 4 pi square L by T1 square. G minus A, 4 pi square L by T2 square. Adding these two, 2G is equal to 4 pi square L into 1 by T1 square plus 1 by T2 square. So G value substituting here and 4 pi square L cancel both sides, we get finally 2 by T square is equal to 1 by T square plus 1 by T square. Similar problem. Okay, so this is the second model. Okay, so simple pendulum problems are like this. Next, we have to go for spring pendulum. Before going to spring pendulum, you should know about spring. Already in an elasticity chapter, we learned about the spring. The spring is made of elastic material. One end is fixed and the other end force is applied. The spring can elongate. The elongation of the spring is x, f is equal to minus kx. That means x and the restoring force in the spring are opposite in direction. So f is equal to minus kx. Or if you take only magnitude, f is equal to kx. K is known as spring constant or force constant. K is known as spring constant or force constant. Energy stored in the spring, half K x square half f x or half f square function. So we have three formulas for the energy stored in spring. And spring constant depends on nature of material and inversely proportional to length of the spring. Length is more, spring constant is less. And spring having constant k, it is cut into two equal parts. Each part of spring constant becomes 2k, 2k. If it is cut into three equal parts, each part of spring constant becomes 3k. Now a spring of constant k cut into two parts in the ratio m is to n. Their lengths are in the ratio m is to n. Then first part of spring constant k1, second part is k2, k1 is equal to m plus n by n into k. Second part of spring constant k2 is equal to m plus n by n into k. Okay. And a pendulum, this spring is pulled by a solid under it is one. Spring is connected to a load, mass m, kept on frictionless table, pulled aside and released. Then the restoring force acting on the spring minus kx is equal to ma. Therefore, a is equal to minus k by m into x. So comparing this one with the minus omega square x, so acceleration directly proportional displacement, this is a SHM. Omega is equal to root of k by m, therefore spring constant, moment time period of spring mass system, the spring mass system having time period of 2 by root of m by k, this is the spring pendulum time period, spring mass system time period. Time period depends on mass of the block and spring constant only, does not depend on acceleration due to gravity. So this is about the spring. Next, two springs connected like this, they are in series. Then their effective spring constant k is equal to k1 k2 by k1 plus k2. Or 1 by k is equal to 1 by k1 plus 1 by k2, just like the series capacitors. Two springs connected like this, they are said to be in parallel, their spring constants are k1 k2, effective constant k is equal to k1 plus k2 by k2. Effective spring constant k1 plus k2 by k2. So problems based on this is spring pendulum. One, time period of spring pendulum on the earth is t. It is taken to the moon, what is the time period? So on the moon also time period remains the same because the time period does not depend on acceleration due to gravity. Inside water also time period same. On the surface of moon also time period same. At the center of earth also time period same. Does not depend on acceleration due to gravity. Time period of simple pendulum is t. Now, spring pendulum is t. Now, the spring is cut into two equal parts and one part is connected to the same load and vibrated. What is its new time period? First time period is 2 by root of m by k. Now time period is 2 by root of mass, say spring cut into two parts, equal parts. So each part of spring constant will be doubled, 2k. So that is equal to t by root 2. T dash is equal to t by root 2. T dash is equal to t by root 2. T dash is equal to t by root 2. Next, this is the k1 and one part is there and connected to k2. Now, oscillating. What is the time period? Here, this diagram is rearranged like this. So, the two springs are parallel. strings will connect like this. That means the two strings are parallel. Black is in the middle means the two strings are parallel. So ends we can attach like this. So time period is 2 by 2 half, 1 by k1 plus x. Because two strings parallel, effective spring constant k is equal to k1 plus k2. Next, one spring is attached to the load. Spring is constant K. Weight is mg. The elongation is g. And stop, not oscillating. Now, it is further pulled down by x and release. Then it can oscillate with the time period of 2 by root of g by g. So whatever the weight suspended mg, because of that elongation is g. Even the further pulled some distance e dash, somewhat 2 cm or 1 cm, time period does not depend on this, depends on initial elongation e, t is equal to 2 by root of e by g only. Here also, time period is not dependent on acceleration due to gravity, because of the gravitational force it is extended. So from that we got this formula, time period t is equal to 2 pi root of e by g. Okay, so oscillations, total 4 topics. First one about equations of motion in SHM. Second one, phase and phase constant. Third one, simple pendulum and variation of time period, etc. And fourth one, spring pendulum, spring mass system and spring pendulum. So about the spring also we have to learn. Springs series, springs parallel, what happened, the spring is cut into two equal parts, unequal parts, time period of spring pendulum, frequency of the spring pendulum, etc. So these are about oscillations. Okay?